Good evening, friends. This is time for the much-awaited video on trapped traders. And you know, the issue is that 25 years back, when I had started this business, you know, people used to enjoy making portfolios and sitting on them and having patience, etc. Today, they want movement in their favor. The moment they buy a future and or an option. In fact, there is no market even for futures trading. The only thing people want to do is the weekly option, where you buy something for 300 and it goes to 500 in a jiffy, or you buy something for 150 and becomes 250 by end of the day. You know, instant coffee era is this is. So before we move forward with this learning video, let me just request everybody to like, share and subscribe the channel. And if you want our join button services on offer, we have platinum, gold, silver, diamond, copper, etc. So you can go directly to the YouTube join button and choose services and do the formalities for questions. WhatsApp 9871066337 or email at ashwani_gujral@yahoo.com. Now let's first go to the whiteboard and understand what is the basis of this video, what is the logic of the market. So let me open the whiteboard here. Now the market is divided between long and short positions. So if we have any sort of range in the market, the shorts are sitting here and the longs are sitting here. The moment one boundary is taken out, one party is going to rush to cover its position. So if the upside is taken out, people who have written calls or are short on futures will start to cover. Or if we are breaking down, people who are long, their stop losses will be hit and the market will come off. So this is setup number one, where you have a range, and on both sides of the range you have, you know, either long or short sitting there. Then you have patterns like the W pattern, or the M pattern. And this is the second category. Now here you have call put writers who are sitting here, which is the longs, and somewhere here you have the shorts sitting here, because obviously what they are playing for is the market to break this low and keep going lower, but the market surprises them and turns around. Similarly, you have shorts here and you have longs here. The longs were expecting that this high is taken out, but instead the market turns and goes through their stops. Then the other sort of pattern is you have a strong upside and the market makes some kind of a flag and again continues on the upside. The fourth pattern is you have the 200 period average. On any time frame, this is the equilibrium. So if you are below the 200 period average, you go to the upside, find resistance, and immediately start to come off. Or above this zone, you go to the towards the 200 and again find support and move to the upside. In each one of these situations, what you are finding is that either you have a reversal or a breakout, which leads to the market rocketing on the upside. The issue is that if you buy a weekly option, you cannot hang around. If you buy a future, you cannot put more than say, 50 to 100 point stop on Nifty, or at max, 200 point stop on the Bank Nifty. So it's important that the moment you take a position, it needs to move into your favor immediately almost. So let's see how doing that is possible. Now we go to the real life charts on Bank Nifty. Most people think that Bank Nifty is the most suitable to trade weekly options, but I think even on the Nifty, it is fairly useful. I like to implement these strategies on the 15 minute chart. So let's talk about the trade we took on Thursday. Now on Thursday, what was happening here on the Bank Nifty was that because you had expiry, the market went to the previous session low and started to consolidate here. Finally, after some time, say about 12:30, it showed you this kind of move on the upside. So this was a range which you were making, and once you started to get this candle, immediately you went long, and the market, the shorts were sitting here. So this was a very anticipatory trade we took based on the fact that yesterday's low was holding on. You could have bought even on this bar and still would have made money. But buying here was useful, particularly because you had a previous day low which you were supporting. There was a congestion even here. So when things start to come together, you need to take the opposite side. You had this big collapse the previous day. Again, the market gapped up, came down, and somewhere here it was stalling a little bit. So that way, given a situation, you have to see how all the parts are gelling well. And if you bought, say the 34,000 call of 8th of April here, that was for about 274. It went up to almost, I think, 550, 560 before closing at about 500. So those are the kind of returns you make if you are able to figure out where the shorts are sitting. The shorts were here and the shorts were here. So both these places propelled the Bank Nifty higher. On the Bank Nifty, you know, when you get a short covering bar, according to me, an average of 150 to 200 point on the 15-minute chart is a, you know, big enough bar. 45 to 50 points on the Nifty is a decent looking bar. So that way you are able to see that when short covering or cutting of longs happens, you are able to get in. Now let's look at another example. You have this range. Now where are the long positions here? The long positions are sitting here and here. But once you got this big red bar, the stop losses of the long positions which were here started to get hit. Immediately you buy the at the money put or one strike out of money and you got this decline, and it's quite easy to double your money within a very short order, because this was about 33,600 and you fell within no time to 33,200. So again, a very instantaneous trade once you get the right setup. See, the longer the consolidation, the longer the range, the better will be the breakout. So this always you have to see that the pre-setup, the longer it is, the bigger the move you will get on one side. Now let's go back further and see what kind of trades we could have done. Another trade that we took was the day the Bank Nifty got to 32,400. So on that particular day, we came into the market short, and somewhere here we had taken our profits out. We didn't get this, but that was also an expiry day. The moment this bar happened, we went long. Why? Because there were shorts in the system, and this kind of bar meant that more short covering could be ahead. Again, our call options doubled by the time this day ended. So how do you do your money management? You put your stop under this large bar, and generally speaking, if you lose 30% of the option value, you should cut your position, and an average target of 80 to 100% can be kept on the trade. Now, as part of pre-preparation, when I am coming into this day, what I am looking for is that where are the shorts sitting? Now, on this particular day, the shorts, chances are sitting here. So on the next day, the moment this level starts to get taken out, you take your put positions, and by the time the day ends, you are 600 points lower, and that works out. So it is possible to see before the day starts that where would you like to, you know, what which area would serve as the trigger to get into position. This was also a very narrow range day, and with a gap down, I think a lot of things, they came together to get into the put positions. Now again, look at this range getting formed here. Now if you go back, you have this sort of support which is there. And when this range broke down, it broke down this entire support. So again out here, you could have gotten into put positions and the market just collapsed on you. Okay. So that is how you need to construct your trades. Reversal trades are taken when you have this sort of a collapse. So what happened here was that as this collapse started to move sideways, you should be ready, watching out, because the stop losses of the shorts, they came here. So the moment you got this green bar, the market was ready for this 4 to 5 bar move on the upside. How do you exit? You exit once you get these 3 to 5 bars in your favor. Again, if you go back, this was that Mahashivratri day gap. And once the market started to break through this support, say about here, if you went short, I think by the end of the day, you ended up with a very huge profit. So the idea here is that you let the market set up, define the support and the resistance, and only then you start to act on this. Now here, this is a support zone. The market gapped into a support and started to show traction on the upside. So immediately this 3 to 5 bar move gave you a very, very large profit. Your stop was about here. So these are the kind of moves you can easily catch 2 to 3 times in a week once the market is setting up properly in your favor. So again and again, whenever you get boundaries being made in any direction, all you have to do is look at this large bar and get on the long side or the short side, as the case may be. And you get a fairly immediate move, which is what you want in a futures trade or in an options trade. In futures or in option, if your trade is not moving in your favor within half an hour, then you are possibly in the wrong trade. Now you have shorts sitting here, and the moment you saw this bar, you know that there is short covering which is likely, and immediately within 3 bars you get your upside. See, again and again, the markets develop a certain kind of support, and as soon as that support is violated, you get a tradable, actionable move on the downside. You have support developing here, you have support developing here. All you have to do is look for the place where you are likely to find positions on the other side. Look at this range which is getting formed. Okay. So the moment you got this bar, immediately you got in, and by end of the day, you made money. Let's look at some examples from the Nifty chart. On the Nifty chart, again you can see the shorts were sitting around this level, and the moment this got taken out, you had a fairly strong frenzy on the upside. Now you can see here that we have closed, you know, on Friday, which was 1st of April 2021, exactly at the resistance zone. So if we are able to gap up and move higher, you could have a fairly decent gap on the upside. Very similar to the Bank Nifty, you gap down and immediately started to break this support. So if you got into puts here, by end of the day, you made very good money. Okay. For the Nifty, about 45 points is the kind of bar you would need to kind of gauge where there is short covering or where stops start to get hit. Again, if you look back, look at the size of this bar. The moment you enter this bar, I think you get immediate follow through. The issue is that we want immediate follow through. We don't want to hang around, because hanging around would benefit only the option seller. Hanging around on the future side, if there is no momentum, finally, the position will start to move against you. So the only way you can get immediate action is by looking at where the shorts may be there. And it's very easy. Like here, if you are gapping down, the short is sitting here. So the moment you get this green bar, it is obvious that there will be short covering towards the upside. Similarly, out here, the shorts are sitting here. Once you get this bar, even if you have to carry, you are able to get nice upside on the next day. So the idea remains at all points in time to see where the other side is getting hurt. Similarly, you gap down here and immediately, if people went long early in the morning, their stops are below this point. So you start to get follow through on the downside. So this is the kind of trade you need, where there is no conjecture, where there are no views. Because in this kind of a sideways market, you have one view which is saying 14,200, you have the other view which is saying 15,200. So it is best that you are able to do things without getting into this business of views, and make your short-term money and get out. Support broken, again you get follow through on the downside. The problem with having views is that you continue to be against the price momentum and keep hoping and praying that your view comes out right, and that is not good because chances are once the premium starts to go down, it seldom recovers. So this sort of practice and a lot of awareness of where the shorts could get into trouble or the longs could get into trouble can lead to very good short-term trading, which is what most of you want. So with a little bit of practice, I think it is possible to construct fairly decent weeks out of this, and without bothering about what the view is, what the news flow is, etc., etc. This is pure price action stuff, and these sort of patterns, they keep happening all the time. So that should be it. Take care, trade well, and please consult your financial advisor.